wine. And to admire. Very rich. I'm very old and I don't trust the people who will inherit what I've saved up all my life. 3 years ago, I married a young wife. She's been no good to me. I've got no child.
With your permission, Mr. Clay, I also can tell this story.
What's that?
The old gentleman led this sailor to a bedroom which was lighted with candlesticks of pure gold. Was it not so, Mr. Clay? In the room there was a bed, and in the bed there was a lady. The old gentleman took from his purse a piece of gold, a 5-guinea piece, Mr. Clay, and handed it to the sailor.
How do you come to know this story?
Coming here to China, Mr. Clay. You traveled only one ship, so you have a story for the plans.
What's that got to do with my story?
Gravesend tourism. It was a sailor on that ship who told the story. On my way to Singapore, I heard another sailor tell the story. The story they tell never happened. And that's why it is told. It never will happen, Mr. Clay.
I don't like prophecies.
There's a woman in the story. The young miss I shall not be able to get.
I'm paying you to do this work for me. It will be part of your work to find me this woman.
Yes, Mr. Clay.
This clerk might well have been a highly dangerous person, except that ambition, desire in any form, had been washed and bleached and burnt out of him. He was like some kind of insect, hard to crush even to the heel of a boot. And yet there were things not yet to be recounted, which moved like big deep water fish in the depths of his dark mind. He had only one passion, a craving to be left alone, His soul was concentrated upon this one request, that he might enter his little room and shut his door with the security that here no one in the world could possibly follow him.
By the next day, he had decided on the heroine of the story. In the town, she was called Virginie. She was the mistress of another clerk in Mr. Clay's establishment, a young man named Simpson.
Charlie?
I remember he asked me to buy your shawl, so I brought you some of them so you could choose the one you like.
Yes, Charlie didn't want to be seen in the shops buying such things for a woman. What if that might have got back to his family in Europe? So he sent you?
I don't suppose you've got a family in Europe. What's your name?
Lubinsky. Elisha Lubinsky.
I won't ask you what you want of me. You can tell me when you feel like it.
If you know Charlie, I suppose you work with him at the office.
The old American.
Yes, Miss Virginia.
How is he, the old man? I heard he was sick.
He's not well, Miss Virginia. He does not leave his house.
Good. Is he going to die?
Oh, no. And he's even strong enough to make up new schemes. With your permission, I'll tell you one of them. He dislikes pretense. He dislikes prophecies. He likes facts.
Facts?
Yes, but 50 years ago on a ship, he heard a story told. A sailor was walking by himself near the harbor when a rich old gentleman drove up in a carriage and said to him, "You are a fine-looking sailor. Do you want to earn 5 guineas tonight?"
That was in Penang.
Yes?
Not here in Macau. I heard it from a friend of mine, an Englishman, a merchant captain. It happened to a sailor that he knew when he first went to sea.
Miss Virginia, this is a story that lives on ships. All sailors have told me. Tonight I've been left on sea and never come ashore if it hadn't been for Mr. Clay. He made up his mind to have it happen in real life, to real people, in order that one sailor in the world should be able to tell it from beginning to end as it actually happened to him.
If he wants to play a comedy with the devil, it's a matter between the two of them. What's it to me?
Yes, a comedy. I forgot the word. There are three people in Mr. Clay's comedy. The old gentleman who will play himself, and the young sailor, he will himself find by the harbor. But if an English merchant captain has told you this, Miss Virginia, he will have told you that besides these two, there's also a beautiful young lady. On Mr. Clay's behalf, I am now looking for this beautiful young lady. You should come into this comedy and finish it for me.
Oh, Clay's got some pretty strange ideas of a comedy. In a comedy, the actors pretend to kill one another, or to die, or to go to bed with their lovers. They don't really do any of these things. Your master's like the Emperor Nero of Rome, who had people eaten up by lions.
Yes?
Yes, just to amuse himself. But since then, it hasn't been done.
Was the Emperor Nero very rich?
Oh, he all know the world.
And why is comedy good?
He liked them himself, I suppose. Nowadays, who would he get to play in them?
If he owned all the world, he would get people to play in them.
What does he pay you? 30 pieces of silver?
I'm in Mr. Clay's employ. I cannot take on work anywhere but with him. But you, Miss Virginia, you can go wherever you like.
Yes, I suppose so.
Yes, you suppose so. But you have been able to go wherever you like all the time.
I was so angry with my life today that I was planning to end it.
And now you're angry with me. Miss Virginie, Mr. Clay is prepared to pay 100 guineas if on a night appointed by him, you will come to his house.
His house?
Yes, to his house.
My father's house. I played in it when I was a little girl. That house was the only thing left me for